Welcome, friends. Welcome back to Cocktails After Dark. I am just cracking some ice cubes for today's cocktail. Today we're going to do a cocktail out of this little 1951 cocktail book called Cocktails, Tequila Cuervo, La Rojena. And we're going to do a cocktail called the Sunrise Tequila. Now, this is from 1951. And 1951 is within a couple of years of the first rules around what could be called tequila, or what tequila was, what tequila had to be made from, where tequila could be made, all of those things. And those rules came in 1949. Now, the thing about the rules is they're fluid. They change constantly. And if you think you know the rules about tequila today, you probably don't really have much of a clue about the rules about tequila going back into time. And so I'm going to make the cocktail today with two different types of Cuervo tequila, just to kind of exemplify this. Okay, we've got our ice set up. Next, I need a lime, and I'll cut that lime in half. And each of the glasses is going to get half of a lime. And it asks you to put the lime shell in the glass. Now, the rules around tequila today is that you can call it tequila if it's made in tequila from 51% Weber Blue Agave, or Blue Agave, Blue Weber Agave. And I would call that mixto. In a very derogatory sense, I would call that mixto. And that's what this is. But I got my wrists slapped by someone from one of the tequila councils. You can't call it mixto. It's tequila. So we're going to use tequila, this one, which is only 51% blue agave. The rest of the alcohol in here could be derived from anything, probably corn. And it says one jigger. So in goes a jigger of tequila. Next, we're going to use 100% Blue Weber Agave tequila. So what's in this bottle is derived 100% from agave. That's 100% Blue Agave Weber, Blue Weber Agave tequila. It just gets so confusing. And it obfuscates for the consumer what's really happening. You go to the store and you buy this and you think, oh, it says it's tequila. Must be good. And it might be good. I don't know. This might be better, but we're going to give them both a try head to head. And so a jigger of that. Now we need 6 dashes of grenadine, and this is our homemade grenadine. You can find that video elsewhere. And the whole idea of a dash is, the whole idea of a dash is pretty subjective. I have cocktail books going back to the early 1800s, and when you look through the ones that actually list what they think a dash is, none of them agree. A dash is all over the place. So that was 6 dashes of our homemade grenadine. Now we need 2 dashes of creme de cassis. So just a little bit less. I'll be very careful. Or I'll try to be. Now, the last ingredient is club soda. And so I'm going to use club soda. It says sparkling water, but in effect, what they were looking for was club soda. So we fill that. And give it a little bit of a stir.
Hey, Glen.
Hey, Julie Jones. So here we go.
Okay.
The Sunrise Tequila. One made with tequila and one made with 100% Blue Weber Agave tequila.
Okay. So we will see.
There you go.
Okay. It's not a whole lot of flavor.
No.
That's not fair. It's not a big, bold flavored drink. It is a light, kind of refreshing.
It's sitting by the pool.
Mm-hmm.
Like it really is. It's cold. It's liquid.
Mm-hmm.
You taste any different?
Yeah.
Okay. Which one?
They're very different. I mean, I don't know that you could say which one is better, because they are distinctly different. Where this one was the cold, light, refreshing, not a whole, like a very neutral, kind of slightly fruity.
Mm-hmm.
This one has that distinct tequila, and more so than a tequila, just like that smokiness of a... Yep.
So this one is tequila, and this one is 100% Blue Weber agave tequila.
Okay, so clearly that one has a different flavor to it, as a base flavor.
Yeah. Don't call them mixto to the tequila people, because they'll slap your wrist. So... it's not a matter of which one is better. It's a matter of which flavor you like better. You know, if you like the flavor of mixto, then that's the one you should buy, because it is definitely a less expensive option.
Yeah, because I can see that's not a flavor for everybody. No. I happen to like it, but not everyone likes that smoky flavor. Yep. It's like getting something from Isla, right? Like it just.
Yep. And it's not to say that this one is overly smoky, either. Mm-mm. Like, this is not...
And that could also be my lack of the ability to, you know, have enough words to describe the flavor.
Like, right? It's not veering into mezcal territory.
No.
No. But it does have just a distinct flavor.
Like a roasted, nutty kind of...
Yeah, and some of that comes down to the process as well. What process are they using for the piña before they get it into the distillation process? You know, some of them are doing it in an autoclave, which gives a very clean, neutral flavor. Some of them are roasting, it's a really wide category. And to say that it's one thing is almost impossible, because there's so much difference.
And I would say that you could make this with 4 or 5 different types of tequila and have 4 or 5 different drinks. And you just have to choose which one you like best.
And different, and then, you know, play with the other ingredients. To me, it could use a little bit more supporting flavor.
The afternoon of experimentation.
Yeah. So, try the Sunrise Tequila. This is from 1951. This is a long time before the origin story of the Tequila Sunrise. I'm not saying that this became the Tequila Sunrise, but it, I don't know, uses a lot of the same words. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.